Welcome to the first episode of GRE Quant Shortcut series. And in today's video, we're going to be taking up the chapter Statistics under the topic Data Analysis. Before we jump into solving a problem, it is important to know or understand certain concepts and formulas, such as mean, median, mode, and standard deviation. Now, here's your question. The mean of set A and set B are the same. Quantity A is standard deviation of set A. Quantity B is standard deviation of set B. Which of the following is true from the below statements? Now, there are two ways to solve this particular question. The conventional way is where you calculate the mean of set A, which comes down to 2x plus 55 by 5. And the mean of set B, which is 91 divided by 5. Now, when you equate them as given in the question and solve the equation, we get the x value to be 18. Now, use this value and find out the remaining values in set A. Now, the given question requires you to find out the standard deviation. As we recall, the formula of standard deviation is under root summation of squares of differences between the mean and values divided by the total number of values. So by applying this formula to the given set, you would have to find the difference between the mean and data set value and then square the difference. Now let's take one of the data set for an example, which is 10. When you subtract it from the mean, you get 8.2 and you square it, it's 67.24. Repeat the same process for all the values in each set. Now, substituting this in the formula, the standard deviation of set A would turn out to be 4.445 approximately, and standard deviation of set B would turn out to be 4.890 approximately. Hence, it is very clear that quantity B is greater than quantity A, which makes option 2 as the correct answer. Now, while this was a very simple sum to solve, the number of steps involved, all the way starting from calculating the mean, solving the equation, calculating the mean difference, squaring the mean difference, and then finding the standard deviation. But is there a shorter way where you can save a lot of time? Well, of course you do. All you need to do is simply understand and apply the concept of standard deviation. To put it in simple words, it's the average amount by which each data value deviates from the mean. Now, let's try to apply that in the given sets. Now, if you look at set A, except for 10, all the other four values lie somewhat closer to 18.2. Whereas in set B, there are three values, 18, 19, and 15, which are closer to the mean, while 12 and 27 are at opposite ends of the spectrum. So it can be safely concluded that the set value of B are more widely scattered from the mean when compared to the set value of A, and hence, the standard deviation of set B would be greater than that of set A. There you go. Just by understanding and applying the concept, you get to save a lot of steps and thereby saving a lot of time. Now, before we wrap up, here is a very, very important giveaway. We have compiled an ebook with all the formulas you will need to master GRE Quant. Feel free to click on the link and download it. Now go ahead. Try solving this question and post your answer in the comment section. In the upcoming videos, we will be covering shortcuts for geometry and probability related questions. Until then, happy learning.